Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, it's Pixelated Apollo, and you've just made it in time for the Battle of Mirkwood. After the Battle of the Five Armies, the elves have taken many casualties, but that is the least of their troubles, because Dol-Guldur is invading their realm, ordered by Lord Sauron to march deep into the forest of Mirkwood and to destroy the woodland realm. They will kill anything in their path. The elves may be outnumbered, but they are certainly not outmatched. They know their homeland. They must use the terrain against their enemy, and they must use their superior skill. But they are not the only ones that live in the forest of Mirkwood. Great spiders have a nest nearby on the battlefield. Any army that goes near them, they will be attacked. Whether you're an elf or an orc, you will be attacked. And the spiders are pretty pissed off, and right now they are charging for Dol-Guldur. So it seems that they're getting a little too close to their nest, so the spiders are gonna go ahead and charge in. So this, of course, is another scenario built by Paladin Bob. So thank you, buddy, for the battle replay and the scenario. Very awesome. And if you want to play this battle yourself, there's links in the description. We'll go ahead and go into normal speed, and we will check out the army comps and the player names shortly after this little charge here from the great spiders. So here they go, and here comes a volley of fire arrows trying to weaken them, and they're gonna just continue to gallop forward, charge into the infantry, and look at them just hopping their way through the ranks of the orcs. Nothing can stop them. Actually, you know what? This army can stop them. Great spiders are pretty OP, but if you just have like massive numbers around them, you can cut them down pretty quickly. So there they go. They're gonna continue to charge there. And I believe it's like two units of great spiders and one unit of this bandit infantry. And this little bandit rebel force is commanded by Angel Crab. There goes another charge. Oh, epic. And I'm not gonna bother showing his army comp because it's just two spiders and this bandit infantry unit. And they're getting crushed pretty quickly, but it should be interesting to see how many kills he gets. But this is good for the elves though, because every kill matters. The cave trolls are now getting their hammers. They're getting spider juice on their hammers. And the spiders are shaken, but not stirred. And the trolls are now going to charge at the flank of the bandits here. And I'm quite impressed that they're still... Oh, there they go. They break. They break from the battle. As soon as I said I was impressed. There we go. And that is the... That's what's left of the spiders, the great spiders. And they are utterly destroyed. And that army is no longer existing. They are destroyed from the face of Middle-earth. Now, if we look over here, it looks like the elves are pushing forward some sylvan horse archers. And the elves, this is a pretty cool battle because the elves really have to use guerrilla tactics. And they have to try to use the positioning of the enchanted river here to try to destroy their opponent. So it should be pretty interesting on how they face their enemy, because they are just completely outnumbered. It is not even close. But let's go ahead and get started with the army comps. All that we're really going to watch right here is the horse archers push forward and get some harass off on the massive force of Dol-Guldur. So we'll start with the attackers here, the Dol-Guldur force, represented by Mordor. This force is commanded by Hobo Scotty. He's got some scouts for archers. He's got a lot of cheap infantry like the Orc Band and the Orc Raiders. But he also has some elite infantry like the Uruks, heavily armored, ready to go. And he has a catapult. Just a massive army, and it's going to be so tough for the elves to win this. And yeah, right now they are getting attacked, but the scouts are zoning out the elven horse archers. If we look at the second attacking force, let's see, where are they? They are right here, commanded by Mr. Deluxe Penguin. A very similar army, cheap orcs, some Uruks, some goblin band or orc band. But instead of catapults, he has a couple units of trolls here, cave trolls, that are marching forward. And that is the forces, the evil forces of Dol-Guldur. Now we are going to check out the elves, but real quick, the horse archers are now behind the enemy forces, firing at the infantry, I believe. Yeah, the orc raiders. Man, this army is massive. Oh, look at this, a catapult. They're now using their catapult. We have a mid defeat by the spider player. Angel Crab. He's just gonna give up because he has nothing left, which, you know, makes sense. So let's check out the elves. So the elves are commanded by two different players. We have the Sylvan Elves commanded by Diplomat, who has not a huge army, a lot of light elven archers. He's got some forest wardens, and his general over here is in a Sindar archer unit. Here's his general, look at him, looking pretty cool. And he also has the horse archers, and he has more light archers up on this hill using that superior terrain. Hopefully they can get some good kills. And he also has some reinforcements, which I'm just going to show as his whole army. But he has two units of axe infantry. They represent reinforcements that show up 5 minutes later. And they're like the woodland folk who are willing to die and fight for Mirkwood. Just some nice axe infantry. What do we got here? Some woodland warriors. They look pretty awesome. And the final army that we're going to look at is the king's army. King Thranduil. And it's commanded by Paladin Bob. He's got some heavy, Sylvan heavy spearmen. He's got some Sindar archers, which I believe, yeah, here's Thranduil right there. Look at him, that's awesome. He even looks like the character as described in the books. And then he's got some heavy archers, or in the movie. But yeah, he's got the elite king's army. So it's really going to come down to this force. Can his elven ally try to, you know, weaken their numbers before the king's army has to engage? But it looks like it's kind of at a standstill. What was that noise? Did you hear that noise? What the hell was that? That is terrifying. I have no idea what's happening. Alright, so I decided to cut out a little bit of the marching there because it was taking them a little while to get to this land bridge. But I believe they're close enough for the elves to be in range. So it seems like this is going to be like a little bridge battle, but I mean, obviously the elves do not have the numbers to win this fight. So it should be interesting to see if they do like a couple hits there, a couple volleys of their arrows, maybe send down a couple units of infantry to hold them back, and then retreat up this hill. And now they do have some defenses over here, so I'm starting to think that they are going to eventually retreat up here and try to fight and hold and use the superior terrain. The other army is marching to the flank this way. It seems that Paladin Bob is not interested, or not really too much interested in defending this path. He's going to keep his army over on this side and try to help out his ally. And here we go, guys. The elves, not actually, you know what? They're still holding fire. Maybe they're waiting for more elite troops to show up. But I think the orcs are actually being pretty smart about this. Because what they're doing is pushing up their archers. And there we go. Okay, so finally we have some archers over here firing. Fire! And here comes the reinforcements. The axemen. They're charging down like a bunch of crazy bastards, and the scouts are running away. So it kind of it's like Dol-Guldur's kind of just, you know, slowly testing out the elven defense before he charges in his army. And there's no way that he's going to be able to skirmish against the elves. The only reason that he would push up his archers like that is him trying to waste the elven arrows, you know, waste their ammo on a cheap unit like the scouts. My best guess, or I mean, if I was in the position of Dol-Guldur, was just charge forward my infantry, just push everyone at once, because they don't have enough troops to defend that huge area. But instead they're going to push up the catapult, so we're going to see some glorious artillery fire here. And if you look in the background, we see some fire arrows coming down from Paladin Bob's army. Here we go, they're going to come crashing in. Almost hitting the poor axeman there. But the elves over here are stuck on this rock. They are now firing down at this unit of orc band. See, here comes another volley. See it in the sky. It's about to crash down. Yes. Missing almost everything, though. Can they climb up this hill? That would be pretty... Maybe he's just testing it. Maybe he's going to see if he can actually go up on this hill. And he'll commit more forces. But it seems like he's going to commit like 90% of his army up this way, which makes sense because it looks like it's easier to travel on, to march a massive force on. Okay, so back to this fight over here. They're just being really cautious, guys. Pushing up their archers, sending forward the catapult. Oh, they're going to push up the catapult even closer. Not a great angle for the catapult, We'll see what they can do here. And they are running out of time, guys. This is a time scenario, so it kind of forces them to push forward. They're going after the general, actually killing one of the bodyguard. A couple of them are dead now. So yeah, they're definitely trying to target the general. And if they hold, I mean, time is on their side. And the scouts are now pushing forward. Here comes another catapult volley. Oh my goodness. Right into the light elven archers. Again, they're not getting a lot of kills because they're in, you know, loose formation. But let's see if this unit made it up this hill yet. This one unit of orcmen. Nope, not looking like it. They got up to here and then got slaughtered. This poor guy is just like in shock. He's like, I don't even, what happened? Where, I'm just gonna stand here. I don't know what to do. Elves looking glorious. Slaughter anyone that comes near us. Okay, so now the archer skirmishing battle has officially begun. And we have some cav charging down. This is the horse archers that were harassing the enemy earlier. So they might be able to get a good charge here. And this could cause them to chain round. If they destroy the archers, Dol-Guldur's only option is to charge in and use his infantry. Oh my god. Yes, the poor archers defenseless against the cav. And he's going to go ahead and do cycle charge. And look at all the kills he got there. I don't know if that's all from the cav charge or from the archer fire. But here comes another volley. Oh, we got some battle music going on now. Finally, setting the atmosphere. Setting the mood for this glorious battle. Here comes another charge. I don't know how many archers he has, but we'll see. Time is a ticking. Oh, they're just standing there now. Oh, that's not good. Oh, the archers are not interested in killing the cav. Oh, except for that poor fellow. So that was not a good charge. And now we have infantry pushing forward down the hill. So maybe he will commit his army and he will fight the elves. But the elves on the hill here still holding their ground. And actually, you know what? Paladin Bob has repositioned his army and he's now firing down at the horde of Dol-Guldur. He's got his Sylvan heavy archers, which are pretty good at melee. So once he runs out of ammo, he can use them as a melee unit. And here comes the Sylvan heavy spears. And I don't know, like, is he going to be able to contain their forces? Here comes another unit. So he's got like units just scattered all over the place. They're using fire ammo. Let's just watch a nice close up of their volley. Look at right over the mountaintop there, the hillside. And it's going to come crashing down into the orc band. And they're about to charge into some heavy spears. But if we quickly check out the battle over here. Looks like the axemen are now keeping back the orcs. And they're trying to buy time for the archers. He might need to send in more infantry. Oh, and there's like the Witch King. That is awesome. Here comes another charge from the cav. For the woodland realm. Nice, that was a good charge there. You know what, let's go ahead and turn up the music volume a little bit. We gotta hear the beats. Set the atmosphere for this fight. But it looks like the axemen are holding strong. It says victory seems certain, but I don't know how long they're gonna last. Also, the bows are getting a ton of kills over here. They're really starting to group up their forces so they can really focus them down and get some easy kills. Now we have the forest wardens charging in. So they're about to reinforce their lines and try to contain their orc army. But if we head over to this side, we also have a very intense battle going on. Paladin Bob, he has his forces separated, but they're pretty elite and he might be able to contain their armies. Here we go, more spears charging in. Just so elite. So battles going on both sides. I'm really sorry about the choppiness, guys. Sometimes that happens with Medieval 2. It's an old game. And, you know, a battle like this, it's a fairly large battle, so it's a lot of work for the game. More troops charging up the hillside. The spears just holding this position. What the orcs need to do is just flank around. Just get your troops around the spears and attack at the flank. Here's some swordsmen. They don't seem to be doing as well. the king's army keeping back the Uruk and the Uruk halberds. There's the rally. Very cool. Look at the archers up here. I bet they're just racking up a ton of kills. They're way up on the mountainside. Alright, so let's head back to this little land bridge battle here. The forest wardens charging in. I believe the axemen were destroyed there. And we have some woodland warriors that are about to charge in. They gotta support their elven allies. Charge! Protect the flanks. Good timing there, because if they charge past the wardens, got behind them, that would be really bad. But they're running out of infantry, so hopefully he's using up his ammo and he can use the elven archers as infantry. You know, for the elves to win, it's a matter of time. Like, they just have to win through time. I don't think they have enough forces to destroy the hordes of Dol-Guldur. Words are hard. But pretty cool battle so far. Here comes more troops charging forward. So Mordor here is just slowly pushing up his forces. There goes the screech from the Witch King. And let's see what's going on here. Oh my goodness. Just battles everywhere. Small pockets of fighting. We've got the Sylvan Heavy Archers now engaged in melee. That's what they're down to, and they're getting hit hard by the scouts of Dol-Guldur. Same thing over here. Heavy archers now engaged in melee. Oh geez, and here's the trolls. The balance of power is slowly shifting in favor of the elves, but is it going to be enough? That is the question. The spears might be able to handle this infantry here, or the cave trolls. But here's another pocket of fighting. Here's another pocket of fighting. These guys should win their battle. They've got it pretty easy. Could you imagine fighting in the very back of this unit and then looking over and seeing the trolls in the background? You're like, oh man, we've got it easy over here. I'm glad we're not fighting trolls. Oh, this is not good though. Trolls breaking through this defense. But we've got a lot of archers over here. And here is the king bravely standing in the front lines of his archers. Yeah, I gotta kill those trolls. Focus them down. I think he's going for the archers back here. And the Uruk bodyguard. Fire arrows coming down. What a glorious hill battle here. Really cool. So let's go back to the other fight. Infantry still holding strong. He's using every single man. It's like a small handful of troops keeping back the hordes. But he still has a lot of axemen as well. And he's going to go ahead and commit them. Get them into the fight. Charge! The forest wardens are keeping back this pocket of orc band. And the archers are just going to town. So, I mean, that's the best thing to do with the elves. Is just send up the infantry, hold them back, and then just get a ton of kills with your archers. Look at that. It's pretty hard to miss. But they're doing a good job, like really great job using his infantry because it's so limited. He does not have a lot. And I like the fact that he's being very patient, not charging everything at once. He's keeping back the woodland warriors and he's getting a ton of kills. But let's see how Paladin Bob is doing over here. Not good. They need to retreat. Fall back. Oh no, they're breaking through the defenses. The general. Oh, come on. Oh my god. The general's bodyguard taking a brutal charge from the cave trolls. Charge in, King Thranduil. Charge. See if he can take down these cave trolls. There's the rally. I love that rally. It's so cool sounding. And now the archers over here are taking their blades out. Is there any more archers that are free to fire? It doesn't look like it. Yes, all the archers are engaged in melee. And the balance of power is slowly shifting, but it's kind of slowed down a little bit. Because Paladin Bob is having a tough time against this attacking force. The cave trolls are just so disruptive. But let's see what's going on over here. Are they victorious? Yes, they are. Actually, these are archers now, so they can fire from this direction. And Let's see. This one guy, this one spearman is victorious. And he's going to charge at the flank of the spears over here. These guys should break at any time. No! King Thr... No! The king has fallen. King Thranduil, you are dead. How could that be? That is not good. The elves' morale is really going to suffer. But look at this. A huge chain route on Dol-Guldur. Mordor. And they are breaking from the fight, but they need a lot more breaking. I can't believe he died to a cave troll. I mean, you'd think the elves would just outwit a cave troll and just slaughter him, but, you know, what can you do? So, yeah, huge chain route over here. Let's check out what's going on in the other fight. Look at all the death and destruction. This crazy amount of kills. It's down to the axemen. That's what's left of the infantry. But I'm pretty sure his elves are going to be running out of ammo very, very soon. So pretty soon he's going to have to charge them into melee, and that's really what it's going to come down to. If they can hold, oh, we got rotting meat being flung at them. Yes, rally, elves, rally. Such a great fight so far. Oh, is he going to charge in? We'll see. I think he's just going to hold his ground and continue to fire at the remaining infantry of Dol-Guldur over here. Let's go back to this fight, because this is where most of the action is happening. Looks like the elves are winning the engagement. Look at this glorious shot right here. That was awesome. I gotta watch one more volley. Yes. Screenshots. That is so great. Getting some great kills there. I like how he has his elves and waves. And did he defeat the army, the entire force? It looks like it. A lot of the orcs here are running for their lives. And we've got these elves over here completely bloodied up, trying to destroy the scouts here. They should win this one. But do we have any reinforcements for these elves down here? I think he's going... Yes, he's going to continue to pursue. Pursue the enemy. Pursue. Whatever. You know what I mean. He's going to follow the enemy. God damn, words are hard. Great battle. Great battle so far. Great stand by Paladin Bob. But they've got a lot to worry about, because this army is still very, very healthy. They still have their very elite Uruks. But man, I gotta tell you, I think it was a big mistake for this Mordor army to charge and attack in waves. I mean, I know what he was trying to accomplish. He was trying to make it so they would waste their ammo and he could save more units, but I think he could have overwhelmed them quicker. I don't know, it's tough to say. Something you gotta try out. But yes, we do have the light elven archers now fighting in melee. Oh, and the orcs eager to fight them. Still got some ammo though, that's really good for them. And the balance of power still way in favor of Mordor. Let's see if he can turn it around. Oh, nice fight going on. Who will win? I mean, it's tough to say, but I've got a good feeling that the elves are going to win this one. I really do. Oh, and now the general's charging into the fight. They got to stop the infantry. They're taking the hill, guys. They are taking the damn hill. Elves, please continue to fire. Keep up the rate of fire. There's just so many. So many. Oh, these guys are just pushing through. They don't even care. They're going for the archers. Good, good tactic right there from Hobo Scotty. Great job. Very good job. But the general is now stuck in melee. Oh, that was disgusting. Cow meat everywhere. And now their flank, their defensive choke point here is exposed. I don't know. Now I'm thinking the elves aren't going to win this. Like, containing that choke point is really important. But Paladin Bob is now maneuvering over his elves. He's walking them because he doesn't want to make them too tired. Look at this army. Look at this glorious army walk by. This is so cool. The armor on these guys look fantastic. It is really unfortunate that the general died, because his general's bodyguard is still a healthy unit of 36. I just can't believe he died to a cave troll. But one army has been destroyed. It's all about this force. And I guess we can go ahead and just focus on this side and watch the gruesome battle. The general is now down in the front lines. Oh, we have a mid defeat by one of the forces of Dol-Guldur. Lord Sauron is not going to be pleased. He is not going to be happy. Look at the general. He's all bloodied up. He needs to stay alive because Paladin Bob has already lost the king of the woodland realm, King Thranduil. Oh, I see the Uruks moving in the background. They are moving in the background. Orc Maulers over here. So a very bold stand by these archers, and they're just getting tons of kills. If you count the kills with their bows and their swords. Oh, nice. Little stab there. Okay, here we go, guys. This is it. And these Uruks need to cut through. The elves were holding their fire. Now they're letting loose their arrows. And it's crashing down, letting loose hell above the Uruks here. And this is the final push. I don't know. The balance of power is almost 50-50, but it's still in favor of the Uruks. And Paladin Bob's army is here now. So, oh, and they're, wow, look at the range of these guys. That is insane. So more arrows coming way down over here. And we got more elves charging in. They're going to try to hold back the Uruks. And I think the biggest mistake that the attackers made here is not attacking at the same time. They kind of did, but Paladin Bob, he won his battle and had enough time to charge over here. And now his archers are in range, and they're going to support his elven ally. That is crazy. Just a little too patient, I feel like, from the attackers. These Uruks, though, they're nasty. I don't know. It's so close. But the balance of power is slowly shifting in favor of the elves. Dol-Guldur, very ignorant of their forces. They thought they had this in the bag, but they should have known better. The elves are elite, elite warriors. Immortal, who can train forever. Here comes the general, the Nazghul, getting into the fight. Look at his swords all kind of messed up. That's funny. Oh, I don't know, guys. I mean, if he breaks through this force, all that's left are the archers over here. These guys are pretty good. Is that all that's left of Paladin Bob's army? I think so. Oh no, we got some elves over here. Three units of elves. What are they doing? They're just hanging out, seeing who can shoot the farthest. I can shoot further than you. No, you can't. There's a battle going on, you idiots. They're eager. The Uruks are eager. The balance of power is now even 50-50. They need to quickly break these guys. The elven general is still alive. Come on, men. Keep fighting. And I think it's pretty smart that Paladin Bob is holding that position up on the hill, because it's going to give his archers a lot of time. Oh, no. It is down to the wire, guys. His elves are breaking. Now he's going to charge forward and try to destroy the final remaining force of elves. Look at the general. He's like, no, come back. Come back, you beast. You beast of war. Face me. Oh my god. This is it. It's down to the freaking wire. How many more arrows do these guys have? Oh, he's so lucky he still has ammo, because he's going to kill a ton of them. And now he's using fire ammo to try to break the morale. This is awesome. Really cool. I love the elves, man. They look so professional. Ready? Let loose. Now! So this is the final charge. These poor Uruks having to charge through a land bridge. And now they have to charge forward and attack these elves. I don't think they have enough infantry. I think they're getting slaughtered completely. I don't know, but remember, guys, the elves have no general, so they could break easily as well. Oh, now it's in favor of the elves. Let's see how good their melee skill is here. and they charge down the hill. Come on. They gotta kill the general. The Nazghul, he looks pretty healthy. Doesn't have a lot of blood on him. But the balance of forces are even. See, what about over here? Defeat is almost a certainty. He's having a tough time against these elves. And we've got some light elven archers that survived the first fight. Oh, lighting them on fire. Come on. He's trying to use as little archers as possible because he wants to continue to fire at them. But here comes this huge flank over here of heavy archers. This is really good because now the general is surrounded. Yes, rally one more time, elves. Defeat is a distinct possibility. It's slowly shifting. It's still anyone's game. Oh, the elves got a great position over here. Cutting down the Uruks. Oh my god, this is so close. I did not expect this battle to be so close. Oh, come on. Now I'm kind of rooting for Dol-Guldur because the odds are against him. Here's the general. He's now flanking around. Doesn't look good for the Uruks. I just don't think they have enough troops. Uh-oh, what was that? What happened? Did they kill the general? Nope, he's still fighting. Look at him, he's getting some kills. With his invisible sword. He's all bloodied up though, he could die at any second now. With a balance of power now way in favor of the elves. And, oh, the general is charging down the center. I think they're gonna try to flank around these elves and try to break their morale. What? Oh, they're going after the general. They're trying to break the general. Oh no, the general's under attack. He's like, I might lose this battle, but we're taking the general with us. Oh man, was it worth it? Was it worth it? Nah, they're gonna lose now. So that was pretty funny. That was really funny, seeing them charge behind the lines and kill that general. And I believe they're gonna break it any second now. Both generals dead for the elves. And this is going to be an elvish victory, but at what cost? A very sad day. The king is dead. Another general has fallen. And this is going to be the end of the Battle of Mirkwood. A very epic battle, very interesting battle. The carnage went down on this land bridge. Look at the struggle that went down over here. This is crazy. The amounts of orc and elves lying dead next to each other. And then all over here on the hill, you had all kinds of crazy stuff going on. The spears holding. The orcs were just not able to flank around and get behind the spears, which I really feel like they should have done. But I believe the Nazgul is fighting for his life right now. So let's see. Yes, he's running away. So we'll go ahead and fast forward and see what happens. I'm really sorry, guys, but my dogs are barking in the background. I'm just going to let them do their thing. There we go. The Nazgul has been destroyed, and that is going to be the end of it all. And the battle is officially over. The elves are able to keep their realm intact. King Thranduil getting 2,249 kills, and his captain friend there that I'm not even going to try to pronounce got 2,668 kills. So they worked really well together. Good job by the player leading the elves here, the elves that are defending this choke. I forgot the player name. I wish it showed the player name on the board right here, but good job by him. On the attacking side, again, both carrying their weight, getting 543 and 545, so pretty even from both the Mordor players. And the rebel force getting 151 kills. Good job, Angel Crab. Way to get 151 kills. So I hope you enjoyed this battle, guys. It was very interesting. Remember, you can download the scenario and play it yourself. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Oh, real quick, do you want to see the results one last time? Look at all the kills. 433 from one of his archers. I just wanted to show you the results, and we can look at his ally over here. 403 kills by his light elven archers. His archers got a ton of kills. 435, good. 564, my god. Well done. All right, now we're gonna close out of the video. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time.